It's day three. What tip is going to happen today?
Well, we're going to talk about color contrast. And this one is a beefier tip than yesterday because when you fix color issues, you fix a lot of high impact, noticeable issues, not just for colorblind people, but you might enrage someone in brands if you don't have a conversation first. I speak from experience. But it's important. It's important that your brand passes these color contrasts. I've worked for brands whose main brand color doesn't pass with like black or white, and it's just, fantastic. It's not a pain in the ass. So, color contrast. How do we look at it? How do we figure it out? How do we fix it? Okay, how do we test for it? So this is actually the brand colors of a company I used to work for before I got my hands on it. And if you went through our websites and our presentations and all kinds of stuff like that, it looked like this. The color palette that we had was so hard to work with. Greens are notoriously hard to work with, as are oranges, and this palette had both. Even the blue, with how it was being used all over our web properties, didn't pass the minimum color contrast ratio. The magic number is 4.5. So this was a whole bunch of examples. And it wasn't just, the text on a color, but it was also the link colors. So the links were often using this dark green color within a dark gray text. Now, since they didn't have underlines to indicate that they were links, no one could see a difference. I am not colorblind, and I had trouble discerning a difference between the link color and the surrounding text. I actually had some colorblind coworkers come to me and say, "Can you please fix this? Because I can't see the links." this was the color palette. And when I ran it through a color contrast checker, they all failed. And these were, a couple of them passed, but the ones that were used predominantly across presentations, across the web, across all of our digital stuff, every single color combination failed. It was crazy sauce, crazy. So there are a few ways you can test. So when we're in a presentation, if you can get the add-in called BrightSlide, I highly recommend you do that. What's really cool is it will test the colors that are programmed into your template. If you go to BrightSlide and you go to theme colors, click down like that and see this color contrast report. You just click a button and you wait. And there you go. It automatically gives you a slide. It tells you what colors pass and what colors fail, what color combinations fail. And it's testing against that 4.5:1 ratio. So BrightSlide is super, super easy to use and wonderfully awesome. However, I know that not everyone can use BrightSlide. So we'll just take these two colors. I'm gonna copy those hex codes. And now I'm going to go to 8 shapes contrast grid. Here we go. It's contrast-grid.8shapes.com. And when you go to there, it automatically fills out this list here of hex colors. I recommend leaving in white and black. And then all you do is put in your hex codes, one on each line. And I'll just put those in there and it will automatically tell you what passes and what doesn't. AAA is like the highest level of accessibility. And look, black on white, white on black, AAA, that's awesome. You're aiming for AA, a AA pass, which is a 4.5:1 ratio. And we have some AA's. Anything that's red, and it has a little key at the bottom, it says does not pass. And the pucey, yellowy, mustardy color there that says AA18, that just means that you can use that color combination as long as the text is 18 points or larger, or 14 points and bold or larger. So that's a really fast way to double check the colors that you are using in your brand, plan to use in a design that you want to, that doesn't even, you know, you're making up a brand of your own. I highly, highly recommend you going to either 8Shapes to do that, or if you work in PowerPoint all day, get BrightSlide. I mean, it'll help you with a million other things besides just this. And then you just program in your colors into the color theme in an accessible manner. There will be a very, a much more detailed process video on what I go through to make an accessible color theme in PowerPoint down the road. There was one other thing I wanted to show you. In case you want to know what these things look like to a colorblind person, you can go for the really quick and cheap, super fast test that's not going to tell you what it looks like to someone who's like red, green, colorblind or what have you. But if you can't read it in grayscale, then there's issues. So you can do that inside of PowerPoint. Just go to View, and then right here under Color and Grayscale, click on Grayscale. And I'm in Windows PowerPoint for this. And you can see anything that has fail underneath it, it's harder to read than anything that says pass. It's so much easier to read. So yeah, print it out on a black and white printer, or go into the View tab and click on Grayscale. Super easy, quick way to just see what might be an issue. And that's it for today. Tip number 3, I hope you enjoyed it. Again, if you do like this content, consider maybe subscribing to the channel, liking this video if you like it. If you don't like it, then you know what? You don't have to hit the like button. That would be dumb. And then, you know, hit the bell if you want to be notified next time I upload a video. You could probably guess that since this is 24 days of PowerPoint tips or presentation accessibility tips, is that, I mean, for the next bit anyway, I'm going to do one once a day. Normally I post once a week.